Peter can actually say he's southern. Because who denied Jesus? Right? Who denied him three times? And that caused a personal relational suffering between Peter and Jesus as Jesus came across the way. Right then. So Peter sees himself as a fellow elder. He's a shepherd among shepherds. He's a first among equals. And the fact of the matter, when it comes to leadership, when it comes to organization, when it comes to calling, Christ, God has set up authority structures. We don't like that word authority either. But there is a place for submission and authority. And it's not like something that we've never experienced before. We experience it within, we experience it at work, we experience it as though we're in the church. And Jesus actually is another God, and I should say, examples this for us. Who does it appear has the greatest authority in the Trinity, God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit? Now, we all know Father, Son, and Holy Spirit are all but God and equal. Okay? It's not one is better than the other, not one is more powerful than the other, not one is more holy than the other. All equally, God equally holy, equally majesty on high, equally creator of creation. But we see that Jesus gives deference to the Father. So I do not think what the Father tells me, I do not think what the Father says, I give glory to the Father. And then who gives deference to Jesus? The Holy Spirit does. Right? Because who sent the Holy Spirit after when he sent it? Jesus. So all equals, but there's a first among the equals, seems to be the Father. There's a second among the equals, it seems to be Jesus. There's a third among the equals, it seems to be the Holy Spirit. Which is one of the big reasons why we're going in, because third among equals we can often neglect, right, and forget, and we need to get back into that. That's where the study of the Holy Spirit is going. Now, so Peter is this leader of leaders. Remember, even in the Gospels, how Peter, James, and John always talk about Peter, James, and John. And Peter, James, and John seem to be what? The inner circle amongst the apostles. Were they like the A apostles and the B apostles? They're all equal apostles. How about the righteousness? Peter, James, and John have a greater righteousness than the other guys? Because righteousness is what it means to be a Jesus Christ. Receive his righteousness. But they definitely had more face time with Jesus. They definitely had a closer relationship, audience, so to speak, with Jesus, and they were leaders among leaders. They were leaders of Christ. And then, when it came right down to it, on the day of Pentecost, who came out and preached? Peter, even by the religious leaders, was seen as a believer. Right? They were even after him. They went to jail, and he got out. So, just a real quick reminder, because, how an elder says, I am a fellow elder. What does it mean to be an elder? Well, 1 Timothy 3, Titus chapter 1, give us a definition of an elder. It is the same term as bishop. Reading, if you want to turn in 1 Timothy 3, it'll also be up on the screen. I'm not going to comment on this too much, but just to remind you, if you aspire to be an elder, that's a good thing. What is an elder? Well, the qualifications for an elder are this. Beginning in verse 2, it says, a bishop then must be blameless, the husband of one wife, temperate, sober-minded, of good behavior, hospitable, able to teach, not given to wine, not violent, not greedy for money, but gentle, not quarrelsome, not covetous, one who rules his own house well, having his children in submission with all reverence. For if a man does not know how to rule his own house, how will he take care of the church of God? Not a novice, lest being puffed up with pride, he fall into the same condemnation as the devil. Moreover, he must have a good testimony among those who are outside, lest he fall into reproach and the snare of the devil. So you can see he's respected there, he's got his emotions under control, he's got his house under control, he's got his food under control, he's got his alcohol under control, and all of these things. This is someone who is God's working in their life and calling them to be an elder. And when you have someone who's in leadership, the interesting thing about leadership